Let's imagine that we have a reservoir whose pores are isolated from each other. To produce from such a reservoir, you have to drill a well every few feet. By comparing drilling costs to the revenue that you may achieve, you will conclude that it's not economic to produce from such a reservoir. For a reservoir to be economic to complete and produce, it must possess an essential property called permeability. This video will cover the basic concepts of permeability. Permeability is the capability of a rock to allow the passage of fluids through it. Permeability depends on the interconnectivity between pores, so it is controlled by pore throats. Permeability is measured by a unit called Darcy. 1 Darcy is equal to 9.87 times 10 power negative 13 meter square. This is an indication that permeability increases with the increase of the pore passage or pore throat cross-sectional area. Permeability can be classified into 3 major types: absolute permeability, effective permeability, and relative permeability. We will discuss each one of them briefly. Absolute permeability is the capability of a rock to conduct a fluid when it is the only fluid that exists in its pores. While effective permeability is the capability of a rock to conduct a specific fluid when its saturation is less than 100% in the rock pores. As for relative permeability, it's considered as the ratio of the effective permeability of a fluid at a specific saturation to the absolute permeability of the same fluid at 100% saturation. It varies from 0 at 0% of the fluid saturation to 1 at 100% of its saturation. As a conclusion, absolute permeability is a property of the rock which is only dependent on the type of a rock and its properties. However, both effective and relative permeabilities are also dependent on the properties of the fluid to be conducted. There are many factors that affect rock absolute permeability. We will discuss the major factors briefly. Number 1. Grain size. As grain size increases, pores and pore throats existing between these grains also increase, leading to an increase in permeability. It was discovered that the rate of fluid flow is directly proportional to the square of the grain diameter. Number 2. Mode of packing. Where permeability is equal to 10.2 d square over c. C is called the packing constant, which depends on both mode of packing and porosity. Number 3. Overburden pressure. It causes compaction of the rock grains closer to each other, causing a dramatic declination in porosity, which may cause extremely high drop in permeability that may reach 60% reduction. Number 4. Reactive fluids. These fluids may cause an internal change in the geometry of the rocks, where it can increase permeability by erosion and dissolution of rock grains, or it can cause the opposite by forming solid precipitates which may block pore throats. Number 5. Clay content. This can reduce rock permeability in two ways. The first one is by acting as cementing material between grains and hence plugging pore throats. The second one is by clay swelling, which is caused by reaction of clay and water. Number 6. Rock tortuosity. It is a measure of the geometry complexity of a rock. The more it is, the harder the flow of fluids and hence the lower is the permeability. As we discussed before, porosity is essential to calculate the original oil in place. However, we can't know the actual reserves that can be produced from a specific reservoir without knowing permeability. If you liked this video, please support us by hitting the like and subscribe buttons below. Don't forget to share it with your friends for their benefit. Thanks for watching.